Hello friends, welcome to Smart News Digital. Today let's see the current affairs of 1st August 2018. The topics on the table we'll be covering today, let's see them in detail. The first article we are going to see today is regarding the draft. The National Registry of Citizens is meant for the purpose of giving citizenship to citizens of India in the state of Assam. This came to prominence because of the illegal immigration in the state of Assam from the neighboring country of Bangladesh, which has been happening since the year 1971. For the first time, the NRC was made in the year 1951, and after 1951, this is the first time it has been updated. The National Registry of Citizens enlists the member's name based on the 1951 NRC or the state's electoral rolls prepared till the midnight of March 14, 1971. This NRC is very much exclusive only to the state of Assam in India, and it does not apply to any other state. The year 1971 was chosen as a base year because it was the year in which there has been a war in eastern Pakistan and a new country of Bangladesh was born. In case if the applicant's name is not in either of 1951 or 1971 list, the applicant has alternative options to enroll his name in the NRC registry. One can provide documents such as tenancy record, citizenship certificate, permanent residential certificate, passport, court record, or any other refugee registration certificate to enlist their name in the registry. This 1951 NRC data, along with the electoral rolls until the year 1971, together are collectively called as legacy data, as they form the base data based on which the further NRC registrations are made. Now let's see what Assam Accord is. Assam Accord was signed in the year 1985. The Assam Accord is a memorandum of settlement which was signed between the Government of India representatives on one side and the leaders of Assam Women on the other side in the year 1985 in New Delhi. Due to the war which ended in the year 1971, there was a widespread immigration of the Bangladeshi citizens to Indian state of Assam. Because of this, there was widespread agitation in the state of Assam between the year 1979 to 1985. This Assam Accord was signed as a settlement to this problem, and this ended the Assam agitation temporarily. This accord consists of three categories. Number one, all those foreigners who have entered Assam between the year 1951 and 1961 will be given full citizenship along with the right to vote. The second category consists of migrants who have entered India after the year 1971, and they will be deported according to this accord. And third category consists of the people who entered India from the year 1961 to 1971. They will be denied voting rights for about 10 years, but they will enjoy other rights of citizenship. This draft NRC, which was released now, excludes almost 4 million people. This 4 million may include both illegal immigrants as well as rightful Indian citizens. The problems involved in this whole NRC is, the NRC bureaucracy are very small in number of about 55,000, but they have to deal with strict regulations of time period which may have effect on the efficiency of data collected. Adding to this is the subjectivity of data of NRC 1971 and electoral rolls which is collected between the year 1961 and 1971. The consequence of this is some of the illegal immigrants are included in the list and some of the legitimate Indian citizens can be excluded from the list. The draft NRC is also in conflict with the Citizenship Bill 2016. The Citizenship Bill 2016 tries to give citizenship status to the Hindu immigrants from the state of Bangladesh, whereas it declines citizenship rights to the Muslim immigrants. This may create Hindu-Muslim conflict in the region of Assam. India, being a democratic country, must address the issue instead of just leaving the integrated citizen stateless. The second article deals with the right to privacy issue. A 9-judge bench in Justice Puttaswamy v. Union of India gave judgment saying right to privacy is an inherent part of fundamental rights of all the citizens of the country. So suggested the government to make an exclusive law to safeguard with the person's informational privacy, which is called as data protection now. Based on the judgment, an exclusive committee was formed, headed by Justice Sri Krishna, and it submitted the draft data protection bill in the year 2018. This right to privacy becomes extremely important in this 21st century with increase in the use of information technology in almost all the sectors. With the expansion of Aadhaar, which consists of the biometric data of millions of people, this right to privacy becomes even more important. This judgment will give right to sexual orientation for the LGBT communities who are so far criminalized under Section 377 of Indian Penal Code. This judgment also addresses the conflict between the right to privacy versus the right to national security by giving a balanced stand. The judgment gives way to the values of freedom, autonomy and dignity, which are part of our Indian Constitution. The third issue deals with Operation Flood. Recently, there is a huge protest by the dairy farmers against a dip in the dairy prices in New Delhi. The Operation Flood was initiated by Dr. Varghese Kurian in the year 1970. It was a project of National Dairy Development Board, and it made India's dairy farming the largest self-sustainable rural development generator. The program also made India's dairy the world's biggest dairy development program. The program was implemented in three phases with broad objectives of increasing the milk production, augment rural incomes, and fair price for also the customers. This Operation Flood was criticized for giving more importance to the imported breeds of cattle, which resulted in decimation of the Indian breeds. The next article deals with the public-private gap in Indian healthcare sector. A recent controversy broke regarding the lack of transparency in functioning of the transplant program in the state of Tamil Nadu. This controversy highlights the increasing cost of the healthcare sector, especially in the private healthcare. The 3-year action agenda of Niti Aayog emphasizes to prioritize preventive healthcare rather than the curative healthcare, which is dominant in the overall health sector in India. The new Ayushman Bharat scheme, which was initiated by the central government last year, gives secondary and tertiary healthcare to socially and economically deprived people up to a cap of 5 lakh per annum. However, surgeries involving human transplantation are a bit expensive and they go beyond this 5 lakh per family cover. The increasing dependency on the private sector by the government is also another problem. The subsidies given by the government to the private sectors are from the taxpayers' money. However, the people who are benefited from the subsidies are the people belonging to the upper economic strata. Added to this problem is a problem of distrust. The people trust the doctors in the private sector hospitals, whereas they fail to trust the doctors from the government hospitals, even though they are similarly educated. These problems are called for reforms in the medical sector domain. The Indian medical sector requires more health professionals deployed in the primary care, especially in rural areas where 70% of Indian population resides. The quality of healthcare provided in the government sector hospitals needs to be enhanced, whereas the cost of care in the private sector hospitals needs to be reduced. Lack of uniform database having information about the patients across India creates a data asymmetry which leads to poor healthcare system. There also is a need of regulatory and accreditation agencies for the healthcare in both national and the state level to enhance the healthcare delivery in the country. The fifth article we are seeing today deals with the Syrian peace talks. There has been talks initiated between the Kurdish rebels and the President Assad in Damascus recently. This is the first peace agreement signed between both the parties after the long-fought civil war in the country. And this may establish a democratic, decentralized, a new form of system in Syria. The Kurdish rebels who fought against the ISIS along with the help of USA forces have a strong hold in many parts of the Syrian country. A place called as Deraa was in news. It was the birthplace of whole Syrian rebellion. It is located in southernmost tip of the Syrian country. Many places in Syria are recently in news, which are important for the prelims perspective. For example, Aleppo, Hama, Damascus, Golan Heights, Deraa, etc. can be asked in the prelims questions. Syria as a nation is surrounded by Lebanon, Israel, Jordan, Iraq and Turkey. It also has Mediterranean Sea on its left side. Last article we are going to see today deals with the safeguard duty imposed on the solar cells. The Indian government has imposed 25% safeguard duty on solar cells imported from China and Malaysia. A safeguard duty is imposed by a country when there is a sudden rise in the imports, which may affect the competitiveness of Indian domestic industry. The safeguard duty is imposed only for certain period of time, thus giving grace period to the domestic producers in order to adjust to the market trends. The safeguard duty is imposed by Director General of Trade Remedies based on the application forwarded by Indian solar cell manufacturers. On one hand, this may help the Indian domestic solar cell manufacturing sectors. On the other hand, it may affect the existing products which are depending on cheap solar cell imports from countries like China and Malaysia.